intimidating, fearsome. No one can stop Rommel, he thinks. But Kindelach, the Eibishter, had other plans than this Rosh Rommel. And the Eibishter helped that this small little army, this small little British army, led by Field Marshal Montgomery, attacked Rommel himself in the desert of El Alamein, opening fire with huge cannons, artillery cannons. Dropping thousands of bombs. Rommel tried to regroup his army, but it was too late. The British had caught him by surprise. He didn't think that they would be able to face off with him, that they would be able to attack him with such force. It was too late. He tried to gather and rally his tanks, but the British had beaten him. He would have to retreat and run back into the desert from where he came. And the desert fox was now running like a frightened fox.
And according to those who study the history of war, this decisive battle was the battle that changed the tide of the war and eventually led to the defeat of the Nazis in 1945.
And the Irish world, Kindelach, thought and still thinks that the battle was won and lost against the desert fox on the sandy deserts of El Alamein. But the real world knows the truth, that the battle was won the night before already, on the foothills of Yerushalayim. So the old man now turned to my grandfather and my uncle, said to them,
Du siehst die Meiche, was mich juckt die mehr wegen eurer Futter in eurer Seele, Reb Shmuel Hillel Shenker. This is the story that they say over from your father and your grandfather, Reb Shmuel Hillel Shenker.
If you don't believe me that the story is true, go into Yerushalayim and ask for the pinkis of the Chevra Kadisha, the ledger book of the Chevra Kadisha, and there it is written, this very story that I told you today. Then my Zayde turned to the old man and asked him his name. The old man said,
My name is Chaim Yeshua.
So my grandfather Taka went together with my uncle, to look at the pinkis of the Chevra Kadisha.
And they looked it up, and the story was taken written in the pinkis of the Chevra Kadisha. And after the story, the 10 names of the 10 Tzaddikei Yerushalayim who accompanied Reb Shmuel Hillel to Har Tzion on that fateful night. The last name was a man by the name of Chaim Yoshua.
So now you see, Kindlech, it's not as the world thinks, that battles are won and lost between soldiers and generals on the battlefield. And even a bigger mistake that the world makes. They think that battles are won and lost by the presidents, kings, and prime ministers who sit in their capitals, New York, Paris, Moscow, London, Tokyo. No, not at all. The battles are won and lost in the cities that are capitals in Shamayim. Yerushalayim, Bnei Brak, Lakewood, Borough Park, Williamsburg, these are the places where there are Yidden that are learning and doing Torah and mitzvahs. These are the places where the battles are determined to be won or lost. And so, Kindlech, you have to realize that on your fingertips, there is a great koyach, a great power. You must realize what kind of power you have by sitting and learning and by doing mitzvahs. And you must never forget that you, and every child out there, when you sit down and learn a Pasuk Chumash or a Blat Gemara or do a mitzvah, you can change the course of the history of the world.